Man, you know, it's fucked up, bro. Like, I feel like if you're a man and you just live on your own, or you're a man, like, especially, like, in your older years and shit, if you're just the older man with no family, no children, no wife, just by yourself, you know, you kind of start losing that will to live, man. Like, and I'm talking about older years. Like, I got an uncle right now, man. I feel so bad for him. I've spoken to you guys about him before, my TFL uncle, man. This poor man, bro, he got cancer. I'm not gonna say where. But he's got cancer, and this fool's just like, they told him he has cancer. They gave him the diagnosis today, or like a few days ago. And this man literally, like, he's choosing, like, seppuku, bro. Like, he's choosing to just die. Like, what the fuck happens to your spirit as a man when you just are a man just on your lonesome forever? Like, I feel so bad. This is the son, husband, uncle that I talked to you guys about that just sacrificed his whole life taking care of my grandma. And now, like, she's been dead for a few years or whatever, and like, he's got cancer now. Like, that's some fucking bullshit, dude. Like the TFL, you know, luck or whatever, like, that shit will follow you in every aspect of your fucking life, man. In every aspect of your life, that TFL, that black pill, if you want to say, that bitterness, that shit's gonna follow you, bro. Like, my uncle literally lost his fight, bro. They're offering him chemo. They're telling him to go to chemo. They're telling him, like, that it's not spreading, that it's still, like, fixable if he starts chemo. But he's literally lost his desire to live, bro. He's on some like, Japanese seppuku, you know, shit right now, bro. Like, that's fucking insane, dude. Like, what? No pussy, no family, no love, no warmth does to a motherfucker. You just choose death instead of fucking living. Like, he's young still, too, like, you know, relatively young. I mean, he could still live another 10, 15, 20 years if he chooses to. But it's like, damn, bro. Like, that's what fucking happens to your psyche. That's what fucking happens to your fucking desire, to your mindset, when you just have no fucking family, you know? You have no fucking people in your corner, no woman, no wife, no children, no children to push you, to motivate you, to... Like, that's sad, dude. Like, at one point, you're gonna run out of copes, man. At one point, you're gonna hit that fucking breaking point where you're just like, I want death. You know, I want seppuku. I want fucking, you know, an honorable death. I tap out. Like, damn, bro, that's so sad. Like, we're gonna hit that point one day. Like, one day video games are not gonna hit. One day the weed isn't gonna hit. One day the alcohol isn't gonna hit. One day the fucking, you know, the TV shows, the fucking, the whores, the fucking prostitutes, the torso jelly, you know, like, all that, at one point, all that shit's not gonna make it worth for us to even keep pushing, you know? Like, my uncle, man, my TFL uncle, bro, like, he's just, his life story is terrifying, bro. Like, the thought of ending up like him, which I'm very much on my way to do, is terrifying, bro. Like, at one point, you know, you gotta choose, man. Like, that's fucking crazy. You gotta choose a path, bro, or that's gonna be your fucking future, you know? Like, you're just gonna be taking care of mama, and then once you, like this guy was literally a fucking son husband. Like, they ruled every aspect of his life. They would tell him his fucking bedtime. They would tell him what time to be home. Like, this guy was literally like a slave, dude. And then he finally is free. And like, a year later, he gets cancer. And like, he's just lost all his fucking desire to live, dude. He's literally opting out on the chemo. Like, just... That's fucking black pill, dude. That's fucking gnarly. Not even finna front, bro. Like, that's pretty fucking gnarly. Like, that's sad, dude. Like, that's my uncle, you know? I feel bad. But there's nothing we could do. Like, I get him. Like, you hit a point where it's like, there's nothing nobody could do to stop me. There's nothing anybody could do to get me that desire to keep going again. Like, nothing, no uncle, I mean, like, no nephew, no nothing. Like, since he has no real close ties with anybody, he's just choosing death, man. He's just choosing to rot. And I think we could all learn a thing or two off my uncle, man. Like, don't get to that point. We should really try, bro, to ascend in any type of of type of fashion, even money or like, my uncle, he has money, bro. And that's what's fucking cringy about him. It's like he's brainwashed, dude. Like his whole life, he's pretty much been like a fucking do boy that he's brainwashed. He doesn't even spend his money. Like I literally, like people have told him, like, why don't you just rent a wife? Or like, why don't you just pay a lady to come live with you? You have money. Like, and he chooses not to, because I guess, you know, he's just so TFL'd. You know, like you hit a point where you're just so TFL'd that it's like there's nothing that's going to do to make you change your mind. So we, right now that we're young, bro, like, I don't know what the fuck we're going to have to do, dude. You know, we're going to have to run a play. Because we, you know, we got to look at my uncle, bro. You guys got to look at my uncle. I got to look at my uncle, and we got to see a lesson there. Like, we don't want to hit the point where we're so defeated that we don't even battle cancer. You know, like, just peace out, man.